the World Anti-Doping Agency is the authority globally in the fight against doping sports. And Malaysia is a member of the World Anti-Doping Agency's Foundation Board. We are one of the four Asian representatives, signatories to two very important instruments that underscores our seriousness in the fight against abuse of drugs in sports. These two instruments enable us to not only to look at how to fight against doping in sport, but it gives us the authority and the clout to do this properly. Otherwise, it would be very difficult. At the same time, we have the Anti-Doping Agency of Malaysia, or ADAMAS, which is the National Anti-Doping Organization, or NADO, recognized by the Olympic Council of Malaysia, the National Sports Council, and of course, everybody under the umbrella of Olympic Council. Our education strategy should not be just to give people knowledge, because knowledge is not education. Knowledge is just giving information. Okay, what education does is to change people's attitudes and behavior. And to do this, we really have to change their outlook, their mindset about the dangers of doping. To be careful and to be always asking. Of course, after this, we have to organize maybe hotlines or maybe transmit to all the sports management people to tell the athletes, the coaches must know whom to ask and you know where to ask, so on and so forth. Most important thing is to generate generations, future generations of athletes who will explore to the nth degree genuine methods and modes of physical preparation. Okay, right now, the majority of our athletes, even though we have world-class athletes who are following their own, you know, their own way in their careers by really working hard, like Datuk Lee Chong Wei, Nicole David, Azizul Hasni. These people are paragons of virtue in our sports world. And these are the ones that we should be looking up to. They work very hard to get at the pinnacle of their careers. Lee Chong Wei, for example, is probably the most the fittest male athlete we've got, and the same with Datuk Nicole David. You know, she's not the world champion many times over because she doesn't work hard, and of course she doesn't take anything to take the shortcut. So this shortcut mentality has to be something that we have to fight against, and we have to root it out from a very early stage. Because of paramount importance is the fact that they are a danger to health. Okay, anabolic steroids can do a whole host of things. You know, physically, they can damage your liver, damage your kidneys. You know, damage your muscles even, and psychologically, they may cause you to become belligerent and aggressive. And in the long term, we've only begun to investigate what are the long term effects. We know about this. Of course, there are other things like stimulants, strong stimulants may cause trouble with your heart and so on and so forth. There's a whole host of dangers and all that. They can always come and approach us, okay, at the National Sports Institute, or they can go through their respective state sports councils, and we have our satellite centers in 9 states now, and we will open one in at least one in every state will have an ISN satellite center. We have to look at the people who are around the athletes in the first instance, the coach, and what about the medical personnel, perhaps, you know, the sports science personnel. In the past, such people have been involved as well, so that's where ISN has to be careful as well. We have to make sure our staff, people who adhere to what is right in terms of helping athletes, And then there are the people from you know, other people, manager, so on and so forth, you may be involved as well. So we have to look at the whole thing in totality and in comprehensive manner, and we shouldn't be missing anything. And you shouldn't be just looking at the athlete and then trying to punish the athlete, so on and so forth. And then we're not looking at the root cause and other factors which may contribute to this problem being perpetuated. The challenge before us is to not only get athletes who are capable of meeting the physical, psychological, physiological demands of sport, but also the sense of innate sense of responsibility, and we have to train them to be people of high achievement and integrity as well. Our national athletes are competing as ambassadors of the nation, you know, as the pride of the nation.